was the second child of Oliver David Sanders and Claire Goodine Sanders. And of course, his beloved daughter, or excuse me, his beloved sister, he joined and made a whole family. And he continued a lifelong bond with this special person. The three loves of his life were his mother, his sister Barbara, and his wife Frances Jane Aldridge. Frank. He attended St. Dominic's Parish School in Eagle Rock and went to Eagle Rock High. After graduating from high school in 1942, he went to PCC for a while, but like all other 19-year-old men in 1943, he was itching to get into the war. He couldn't sit back and watch. He ended up serving and became a navigator and meteorologist. He was so proud of the wings, and these are the wings. I am wearing my uniform, and this is my dad's Class A uniform that you can see right there from World War II. It is probably, he got it in 1943. We're doing this in honor of him as a military man. We've all heard the stories of his experiences many times over. His service to his country was one of the highlights of his life. He never tired of reminiscing about his time in the Navy. He married my mom in October of 1944. After he left the Navy in 1946, he went into business with his father and opened a photo grading shop in downtown LA that they maintained for 40 years. Dad and mom started family, and in 1945, when I came along, the first of four. Mark followed in 1948, Leslie in 51, and baby Laura in 54. By 1950, he had his own business, two boys, one girl in the oven, and owned his own house. You can't do that anymore. Growing up in our household was hectic but fun. We did a lot of camping, fishing, and hiking. Every summer, there were visits to national parks and wilderness. He taught me how to fish, build a campfire, and fish a tent. He could add a room to the house, build a brick wall, and redo the plumbing or the electrical wiring. He seemed to be able to do anything from my point of view. Dad was my little league coach, my scout leader. He was always ready to help whenever we needed. In 1965, he moved to Shadow Hills, and soon we had our first horse, although it was 18 years old and slow. We didn't want to start out with a feisty horse. Pretty soon, we had three horses, and trail riding became his favorite pastime. It wouldn't be uncommon to find an occasional pig, a couple of goats, or chickens in our home, too. Our dad was a cowboy at heart. He would ride his favorite horse every day, and the last time he mounted a horse, he was in our front yard, and he was 90 years old, and his neighbor saddled up a horse, and we walked up and down the street. Mm-hmm. He loved it. He sold his business and retired in 1990, and eventually found a job with an engineering firm as an assistant to the engineers for another 10 years. My dad and my mom spent a lot of time giving back to their community. They would visit prisons and share their faith with the inmates. Many weekends, you could find them down on Skid Row helping others. They were even arrested and spent a night in jail for demonstrating against abortions, one of his most passionate beliefs. He also raised a second family. When our sister Leslie became ill and could no longer care for her kids, Mom and Dad stepped in and took care of her three children. And she raised them from whatever age they were, and they've all done well. The love of his life preceded him in death, but she passed away in 2006. A year later, Judy and I sold our home down the street, my dad over these past years. I have been fortunate in that he allowed me and my wife Judy to move into his house where we could stay in Shadow Hills. He loved his house and his neighborhood and everybody in Blueville. I know he was right with the Lord, and we had many discussions about him moving on and joining his mom and dad and his sister Barbara and Francis and Leslie. I miss him. I wonder if we hear his bell in the middle of the night. I wonder do I come home from work and have him greet me. Hello, Steve. Have a nice day. He was just like the Energizer Bunny. He kept ticking. Farewell, Dad. And I will see you again.
Oh, sweet.